Ho, 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 ho. Merry Christmas. You're listening to the Never a Straight Answer Christmas Conspiracy Calendar. New episodes every day during the month of Christmas. And here's your hosts, Gaz and Taylor. Hey, and welcome to episode 15 of the Never a Straight Answer Christmas Conspiracy Calendar.
Yeah.
Bloody only 10 days to go now till Christmas.
Yeah, have you done all your shopping?
Nope. Done bits. Done most of it. I probably get most of this done on, Crimbo Eve or something now.
Yeah.
Not really much to get. So, I've paid more attention to this advent calendar than my actual advent calendar, chocolatey calendar, because I've only opened like about 6 days.
Oh, to be
honest, yeah, I've got loads of chocolate to get through.
You're lucky I didn't get one.
Did you not get one? No. I bought myself one. I don't, don't rely on other people.
Oh, no, no.
It's only a quid. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know.
Something to look forward to, innit?
There's no point because I'm giving up chocolate.
I was actually thinking about this, giving up sugar. And I'm trying to work out in terms of how much sugar I consume. I do consume quite a lot. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? And I think, well, is it as bad as everyone says? Have I got a sweet tooth?
Yeah.
I like it, I like, but then again, like that stuff.
But then again, I always put it supposedly one of the most dangerous
diabetes, right, but
in the universe is oxygen, yet we live in it.
Right. Oh, it's corrosive.
It's supposed to be the most toxic.
I suppose, in
the universe, but we're all right with it.
They theorise about other planets having like methane atmospheres and whatnot. We not necessarily what we consider an atmosphere.
Coming here might be
toxic to them.
So they
could be in what are they called now? Like hazmat suits or whatever.
Spacesuits.
Yeah, exactly. Trying
not
to survive.
Not them big bulky fuckers that NASA's got.
Oh yeah, have you seen them new lady ones? They brought out? We've got loads of manoeuvrability they have apparently. Moving on. I've got some fun Christmas facts for you.
Yeah.
So I think the Christmas facts have been pretty fun, to be honest. There's been like stuff from like Coca-Cola and other little kind of bits and pieces about origins.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I thought today we'll look at the origins of Rudolph.
Oh right, yeah. Okay.
So and actually
Botswana. Is that where it's from?
Botswana?
Yeah.
No, why would you think that?
Oh, I was just picking a nation that it could have come from.
Well, maybe it could have come. I'm going to just get the music appropriate.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Since we're talking about,
the
reindeer itself.
That fly.
Oh, yeah, it's like flying reindeers.
Yeah.
So the image of Santa Claus is flying in his sleigh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Began in 1819.
Yeah.
And it was created by the Washington Irving. And the same author who dreamt up the Headless Horseman.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
oh.
So I thought that was pretty interesting.
It
was kind of like, he was quite a creative guy. Do you know, fair play to him. Like, two of his kind of creations have gone on to be like, national holiday icons.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? The Headless Horseman and Santa. I think, in terms of characters for holidays, he's smashing it.
Yeah, that's true.
Do you know
true.
What I mean?
That's
true. The Montgomery Ward department store created Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer as a marketing gimmick to encourage children to buy their Christmas colouring books.
See?
Yeah, so Rudolph was actually invented by a department store. the original Rudolph didn't even have a red nose, because in that day and age, the red nose was seen as an indication of chronic alcoholism.
Oh.
And Montgomery Ward didn't really want him to look like a drunk.
Right.
So to complete the original picture, he was almost named Reginald or Rolo.
Oh, I can't see that word.
Rolo the Red Nose Reindeer.
Well, actually,
Reginald. I prefer Reginald.
Would that song come out, though? Because
who knows?
This?
Well, I think they all go, kind of. Do you know what I mean? They all kind of work.
Well, no.
Reginald the Red Nose Reindeer. Yeah, seriously.
No,
I mean,
no,
if we were brought up,
I
bet there's a parallel universe out there where he is called Reginald.
Yeah, but they're not here, so.
Santa and his magic scooter pulled by Reginald the Red Nose, the Blue Nosed Reindeer.
Elephants. Yeah. Getting pulled by elephants.
Who knows? Probably. You've said it. Yeah. It has to be.
Yeah.
It's fact.
Yeah, camels. People.
Stop it.
Yeah. All right, hamsters.
Yeah, no, yeah, we're going into like the Rick and Morty realms now.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. There's another episode of Never a Straight Answers Christmas Conspiracy Calendar. Today, day 15. Tomorrow, one step closer to Christmas. Only how many more sleeps? 9 more sleeps.
Yeah.
Ah.
So Santa comes down your chimney and
Santa comes
nicks your alcohol.
Yeah. Eats your mince pies.
Yeah.
And then
throws your gifts under the tree
before scampering away. We've got trivia about that as well, actually. So, on that note, I've been Gaz.
I've been Taylor.
Peace
out, Sunbeam.
You've been listening to an episode of Never a Straight Answers Christmas Conspiracy Calendar. I've been your host, Gaz, and joined in the studio, my co-host, Mr. Taylor. If you've got any questions, comments, or suggestions, you can email us at neverastraightanswer@gmail.com or perhaps visit the website at neverastraightanswer.co.uk. From there, you can check out downloadable episodes, news, blogs, reviews, competitions, and much, much more besides. We'll be counting down the Christmas season with a new episode every day in our Christmas Conspiracy Calendar, plus a very special freestyle episode on the 21st of December where we'll be answering your Christmas questions. So, if you've not subscribed already, get over to wherever you get your podcast fix and do just that, and we'll catch you on the very next episode of Never a Straight Answer. I've been Gaz, he's been Taylor, and we'll catch you next time. Peace.
The podcast you just heard was made using Anchor. Ever thought about making your own podcast? Anchor makes it really easy for anyone to get started. It's a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing podcasts. Best of all, it's 100% free. Sign up now at anchor.fm/new. That's anchor.fm/new to get started.